In this video, we're continuing on with the Multiplying Rational Expressions worksheet on the KutaSoftware website under the Infinite Algebra 1 section. I'll leave a link in the description below so you know how to access this free worksheet. Now, number 15, we need to start by simplifying. So our first fraction is x plus 7 over 7x plus 35. But that 7x plus 35, I can pull out a 7 from both 7x and 35. So that'll be 7 times the binomial x plus 5, because 7 times x is 7x, and 7 times 5 is 35, and there's addition in between. So that rational is going to get multiplied to this other fraction. However, I'm going to simplify it by factoring that numerator. So x squared minus 3x minus 40, we're going to see what two numbers multiply to give us negative 40 and add to give us negative 3. And the factors of 40 that will work for this are 5 and 8, where that 8 is negative, because 5 times negative 8 is negative 40, and 5 plus negative 8 is a negative 3. So I'm going to rewrite x squared minus 3x minus 40 as x plus 5 times x minus 8. And that's all over the denominator, which is x minus 8. Now from that, you can see that this problem is rather simple. My x plus 5 in the numerator will cancel out with the x plus 5 in the denominator, and my x minus 8 will cancel out with x minus 8. So I have x plus 7 divided by 7 times 1, which is equal to x plus 7 divided by 7. And that's the solution for number 15. So we took these two rationals, simplified, and then multiplied them together to get x plus 7 over 7. Moving on to number 16, again, we're going to start by simplifying that first rational, and in that numerator, we're going to be able to pull out a 20. And not just 20, but a 20a, because 20 goes into 20, and 20 goes into 100, and a goes into a squared, and a goes into a. So we'll have 20a times a minus 5. That's our numerator, and you can see, if you want to double check, if we were to distribute that 20, 20a times a is 20a squared, and 20a times 5 is 100a, and that's subtracted. And in our denominator, we can't simplify that any further, so that will be a minus 1. So that rational will be multiplied to 1 over 16a cubed minus 80a squared. However, we can simplify this denominator, because a squared is in both a cubed and a squared, and 16 is a factor of 16 and 80. So we'll pull out 16a squared, and that will be multiplied to a minus 5, because 16a squared times a is 16a cubed, and we're subtracting 16a squared times 5, which is 80a squared. And you can see that a minus 5 will cancel out with a minus 5. So rewriting this fraction, I'll have 20a times 1, which is 20a, divided by a minus 1 times 16a squared. So 16a squared times a minus 1. Now I can simplify even further, because both 20 and 16 are divisible by 4, and I have a and a squared. So dividing 20 by 4, I'll get 5, and dividing 16 by 4, I'll get 4. So 20 16ths simplifies to 5 fourths, and if I have a to the first over a squared, my a will remain in my denominator since the 2 is greater than 1. So if you were to work out that law of exponents, I would have a to the first in the bottom. And that denominator is multiplied by a minus 1. So I have 5 over 4a times a minus 1 as my solution in number 16. And quickly working out the law of exponents, so you can see how I get that a in my denominator, a to the first over a squared is equivalent to a to the 1 minus 2, which is equal to a to the negative 1, which is 1 over a. Let's continue on to number 17. In number 17, I need to start by simplifying the numerator in my first fraction. 3 goes into both 3 and 18, and b goes into b and b squared. So I'll pull out 3b and that will get multiplied by b plus 6, because 3b times b is 3b squared, and 3b times 6 is 18b, and that's all over b plus 6, and we're multiplying that by the fraction 1 over b plus 8. And you can see that b plus 6 will cancel out with that b plus 6 in the denominator to equal 1. So we'll have 3b times 1 in our numerator, so 3b over our denominator of b plus 8. So 3b over b plus 8 is our solution in number 17. In number 18, we can't simplify the first fraction, so I'll rewrite that as p plus 7 over p minus 10. I can't simplify the numerator of our second fraction, so I'll leave that as p plus 2. However, this denominator, I will be able to pull out a 7. So pulling out a 7, I'll have p plus 2 remaining, because 7 times p is 7p, and 7 times 2 is 14, and there's addition between those terms. So now I can cancel out my p plus 2, because it's in both the numerator and denominator. So that will leave me with p plus 7 in my numerator over 7 times p minus 10. P plus 7 over p minus 10 times 7, or 7 times p minus 10. That's our solution in number 18. Now for number 19, I'll start by simplifying this first fraction, and I'm going to simplify both the numerator and the denominator. So I can pull out a 21 and an x within that numerator. So pulling out 21x, I'll multiply that by x minus 1, because 21x times x is 21x squared, and 21x times 1 is 21x, and that's subtracted. And that's going to be all over, essentially doing the same exact steps, pulling out an 18 and an x, so pulling out 18x, that will get multiplied to x minus 1. When I redistribute that, you can see that I indeed get 18x squared minus 18x. So that's my first fraction simplified. Now let's look at our second fraction. I have a 6 in the numerator and denominator, so I can cancel that out. Also, my variable x over x squared, that exponent of x in the numerator is 1, so I have x to the first over x squared, which we know is going to be equivalent to 1 over x, because this x will get canceled out, and that 2 will become a 1. Now let's simplify. X minus 1 will cancel out with x minus 1, because x minus 1 divided by x minus 1 is 1. Also, 21 and 18 are both divisible by 3. So 21 over 18, pulling out a 3 from each of those, 21 divided by 3 is 7, and 18 divided by 3 is 6. So 21 over 18 simplifies to 7 sixths, and because I have an x in both the numerator and denominator, I can cancel those out to equal 1. So again, 21 over 18 was 7 sixths, and I still am multiplying that denominator by x. So I have 7 over 6x as my solution in number 19. In number 20, I will not do anything to my first fraction except rewrite it. So 1 over p minus 9. However, for my second fraction, I'm going to simplify that numerator. I'm going to see what two numbers multiply to give me negative 27 and add to give me a positive 6. The factors of 27 would be 9 and 3, where that 3 is negative because that 6 is positive. 9 times negative 3 is negative 27, and 9 plus negative 3 is that positive 6. So my factors of p squared plus 6p minus 27 are p plus 9 times p minus 3. And that's all over our denominator of p plus 9. So you can see that I can now cancel out p plus 9. So I'll have p minus 3 over p minus 9 as my solution in number 20. P minus 3 times 1 is p minus 3, and that's all over p minus 9. And lastly in this video, I'll go over number 21. If you haven't done so before this problem, click that like button and subscribe to my channel. For number 21, right away I can cancel out my v minus 7 because it's in both the numerator and denominator. Now, rewriting, multiplying out, I'll have 10v plus 60 all over v plus 6. I'm going to simplify this numerator. 10v plus 60, if I pull out a 10, I'll get v plus 6, because 10 times v is 10v, and 10 times 6 is 60, and those are added together. So in my numerator, I now have 10 times the quantity v plus 6, and in my denominator, I still have v plus 6. And you can see that v plus 6 will now cancel out to leave me with 10. 10 is my solution in number 21. Feel free to continue on to the next video, where I'll finish this worksheet completing numbers 22 through 28. And as always, like, subscribe, and share.